This is my dining room, and this is where I usually put the food for when we have our Bible discussion group every month. And so what I'm going to do is just put this away. I usually put it on top there, and then I'll cover the table with the placemats. All right, so I usually put this runner. Goes with all seasons because it's neutral. Then I just start putting these placemats around because the whole goal is to try to cover the table as much as possible without using a tablecloth. And usually I usually do the main sides or the main entrees or like appetizers, and then people bring fruit or desserts or something like that. Okay. There's supposed to be one more. Okay, yeah, so that's pretty covered. And then most of this year I've just been using the same basic tools or platters. So I have this cake stand because someone's going to bring, I think, pie, and I usually wash them, dry them, and then I just give it a wipe again. And then this round platter, if you can see that, this is from the Magnolia line, I believe, from Target, so you can get this. And of course, like any video, I'm going to link it in the description below. I'll link all the items down there, so check that out. This is also Magnolia from Target. This is the shorter one. There's also a taller one, and I think the round part might be bigger, too. So the reason I'm showing you stuff like this in this series is because part of being organized is that you get to do more of the stuff that you like to do. So I love entertaining. I love having people over for dinner. I like a small dinner party. I like a large party. And we like these Bible study groups that we host. So like I said, I use the same basic things. I've been using the same ones for the past year, maybe 2 years. And that makes it easier so that you don't have decision fatigue. So I invest in the items that I want to use and that look pretty to me or are aesthetic. All right, and then so some other things that I have, I usually use is this holder. And I found this, I believe, at TJ Maxx, okay? And just go there, you'll always find something for entertaining there. And I like this because it has four sections, and I usually put, like, let's say fork, knife, and spoon, and then I can put the napkins. The other thing that I've done in the past couple years is just to get items that are more sustainable or environmentally friendly. So these are supposed to be recycled, you know, certain percentage of recycled or more compostable. And same with these types of utensils, or biodegradable, that's the word, biodegradable. Okay, so forks, knives, spoons, and then I put a few of the napkins in here, and then I kind of put them at the end of the table too. So I've also found kind of the same type of setup. I put the tray here for the utensil holders, and usually I'll put the plates here, so let me go get those plates. And then down there is where I put the dessert, so I go ahead and put some small napkins there. And I just get the same size napkins. You know, I used to be into, like, should it be dinner napkins size or cocktail napkins, whatever. So I just use the same one, and I'm just going to show you this little party trick that I learned from a caterer. I was at a wedding. And I saw them setting up, and this is what she did to the towels, or to the napkins, to, instead of just it being a block, she turned it like this. And let me show you how that looks like. Let me see, yeah. It's just a little bit prettier. And then, of course, you take the top off, because that's the one your hand was all into. So I just put it there. You can put, like, a little plate, which I'll go get to put the napkins on top of. Okay, these plates are also like recycled and more biodegradable. I'll put the links because I do love them and they're pretty good price. I searched on Amazon and found a good price. So here's where I'll put the dessert place, and like I said, I just put it on top of the napkins on top there so that it just feels cleaner and is cleaner. And then I just put the plates over here by the utensils. So usually the flow is the next thing I think about, is that, and it's been the same flow where you kind of start here and go down there for the dessert. And sometimes I have another appetizer here because the table's small enough. It's not like a big buffet room or banquet hall and you're like, what's at the end of the buffet? I mean, if you just stand here, you could see everything. So I'm probably gonna put the fruit platter here. Okay, dessert goes there. If somebody else brings dessert, you know, we'll just make some space. And I am just doing some appetizers today. I do have a salmon burger. So this will be for kind of, oh no, I'm gonna have the salad there. We are having salad. So salad there, fruit here. I have jalapeno poppers, and then maybe the salmon over there. So you just play around with it. It's no big deal. All right, this is my bowl for the salad. I got it from also the Magnolia line at Target. I love it. It's a nice depth, and I found that it's a pretty good size for when I entertain. And I usually make, if I have to bring the salad somewhere else and it's more than that, then I just make it in another bowl, put it in here, cover it, but it's good to go. And so for this at my house, smaller group of people, or not so many people, one bowl works. And people in this particular group, people love salad. All right, so I hope you can see just even kind of the theme, right? It's like wood, and it's like the brown or the beige. And so just keeping it neutral like that, I mean, you could go with all white. Of course, some of you like more of the festive colors or whatever, that's completely fine. But me personally, I just wanted something neutral so that it goes with all kinds of food that we serve. And sometimes it goes with all kinds of themes. Also, white is perfect, but I just haven't been into like white this whole last couple of years. So the wood has been great. So I'm just glad that I haven't gotten tired of it. All right, so I also got these recently, probably a few months ago. These are my new everyday plates. I absolutely love them. The brand is here, Mora Ceramics. You can get them on Amazon. I have the whole thing, everything from them, or most everything, at least the basics, the large plates, the salad bowls, or the bigger bowls, the cereal bowls, the smaller bowls, the salad / dessert plates, and the big mugs, and then the smaller mugs. Anyway, I'm gonna use these for the jalapeno poppers. So that's salad, that's a salmon burger. So I'm gonna put these before that. And I'm gonna go ahead and put two, because I've got 12 of them. I'm not sure how it will fit. And then I'm gonna leave a little bit of space for plates, and that's where I put the serving utensils. I bought a bunch of these gold cake cutters. I like 10 of them. Because sometimes I help do the potluck for church, and so I just bought a bunch of those. I'm gonna put it near where the cake stand is so that they can grab it right there. You saw the plates and the napkins, and then this one is the tongs. I think I got a few of these from Walmart. I do plan on getting new ones, like bamboo ones on Amazon that I saw my son got, and I really liked it. So I'm just gonna put it over here, and I'm just gonna put one because there's two plates of jalapeno poppers. So I could just put one plate, but I just wanna go ahead and put the two out so I don't have to be looking at it, seeing if I need to refill it. I'll just put everything out. So I just need one pair of tongs. All right, the next thing I gotta do so it gets cold is to fill up the beverage cooler. So what I usually do is I order from Walmart, but I just kept forgetting this week, so it's pretty empty. So I'm just gonna put the ones that I got, I just got a few, fill that up as much as I can. But one of the things that, as far as getting organized for entertaining in your home, just why being organized in general is great and is something that I really want to help you get organized in all aspects of your life,
because things like this, if you like to entertain, you like people to come over, you want to be hospitable, you're not going to have the, you know, can't have anyone over syndrome, right, that the fly lady has shared about. One of the things I've done is that I went through my systems and processes when I have people over, example, like having the same type of platters, but also this mini refrigerator where I saw each time I'd have to think of getting ice and then the ice bucket and where am I going to put the drink. So I went ahead and I got this. And so when I have guests, whether it's a small dinner, a dinner for two, a big party, whatever, I just tell everyone to get their drinks there. So I think about the group, you know, if you have small kids, you can put juice boxes there or whatever they prefer. If you have, you want, it's an adult party, you want to put beer and whatever, you know, alcohol in there, you could do that. I do actually have a separate wine fridge, but this is for beverages that they can drink, even bottled water, if you want to serve bottled water versus in the igloo, that can work too. I have a couple calamansi, that's for me, and I put it way up here on the top portion. That's how much it's filled. And then I usually just keep a basket of some type of snacks up there. I also have my coffee station set up here. It's an espresso. I just filled up the water. I didn't order new coffee because I forgot to, but it's only a few people if they want. It's ready. You have the frother there, have some creamer and all the stuff you need to, you know, sugar and stirs and cups there. But for this group, I use the actual mugs, not the to-go mugs. I usually cook for events like tonight or gatherings, but it was just such a busy week. So I went ahead and got these bacon-wrapped jalapeno poppers from my local grocery store. So it's pretty decent. And there are no cooking instructions on the, you know, but so we're just going to watch it and make sure it's good. And usually for things like this, or most things that I bake, I put it in the pan that's for our toaster oven. And the reason I use my toaster oven a lot versus the regular oven is because I live in Arizona and I've just learned to use the toaster oven because my house just gets too hot. So so all 12 pieces fit in there. So that's going to be perfect. So I'm going to pop that into the toaster oven and we'll move on to the next thing. All right, so now I'm going to make the fruit platter and hopefully it looks like a pumpkin. I went ahead and washed my hands, by the way. I may not have enough oranges, so we'll see. Right, I forgot I had one more dish, and that is barbecue chicken. And I'm going to cut these in half and then put them around. So these are the Cheesecake Factory bread, which are great. I mean, it's better in the restaurant because it's more fresh, but this is fine. All right, so I'm going to put these all around and just kind of put them close to the bowl. Right, the salad's pretty easy today. No cutting. I'm not putting any extra vegetables, but this is a spring mix. Okay. And then Asiago kale. Bit more spring mix. All right, I will cut apples, right? But I'll do that at the very end. sunflower and pumpkin seed mix, salted, roasted. And then, of course, we'll toss all of this right before serving. So, oh, I'm sorry, dried cranberries. That kale came with this, but I'll probably just use the cheese there. Okay. I'm trying to be better at salads or serving more salad. And one thing I know is that you just try to make it different colors. I wonder if this is worth putting. Yeah, smaller croutons, I guess. And then I do have these croutons that I can add at the very end, just a few more. Okay, don't forget that with the apples. So I'll show you this after it's all tossed. And the last thing I'm cooking is salmon burger. So this is already made. Just put a little oil, and then you just cook it on both sides. Okay, so it's a pumpkin. Okay, this is the finished table. So my friend finished up the avocados, the apples, added some more cranberries and the pumpkin seeds and some croutons. There's the balsamic vinegar. We'll toss that in a little bit. And then here are the salmon burgers. So these salmon burgers aren't the best ones. I didn't get to go to the store where I usually get it. So she had to go ahead and cut it. But anyway, it's still yummy. And I made some mayo with relish to make tartar sauce. Have the spoon there and the tongs, and then these are the bacon wrapped jalapeno poppers. Then that's the bread and the chicken barbecue, waiting for my friend to bring the dessert. And then here's the pumpkin that we made. See the apple for the stem up there, cuties or mandarin oranges, strawberries, blueberries, and grapes. So anyway, hope you enjoyed this, and I'll pop a picture in here once the dessert gets in, but hope you enjoyed this. This is what it normally looks like. Try to serve a few things, and I'll see you in the next one. Hit that next video if you want to see more of how I set up things when I'm entertaining. Bye.